The Friends of the Library and Friends of Art are very special. Between 1970 and 2011, the Friends have purchased more than 126 art objects for the library's collection.
The Friends of the Library is a nonprofit organization that exists solely to support the library. Our net profit goes to support the library, to support the programs and services offered.
The Friends of the Library first started supporting the gallery and the library's art collection more than 30 years ago, when our gallery director then, Larry Peters, approached them with the idea of having an art contest to have a local or regional competition. And the Friends of the Library supported the competition itself, all of the publicity materials, getting the word out, getting the work to the gallery, and then also sponsoring purchase awards. They started building our contemporary arts collection. That, for the gallery, has probably been the biggest long-term contribution the Friends have made, in addition to many of the Friends members volunteering in the gallery.
The Friends board was so excited about the Topeka competition that they decided to go ahead and fund it on a regular, ongoing basis, year after year. And I think that was one of the very first things that the Friends board decided to continue doing annually. The Friends of Art group was formed mainly for three different reasons. One was to provide advocacy for the gallery and to make the public aware that there was a gallery in the library, because, you know, many libraries do not have art galleries. And also, the Friends of Art are passionate about art. With their membership, they have provided an opportunity for funds to be available to purchase works of art on a continual basis.
Without the Friends' support, we wouldn't be able to bring the quality of art here for people to study. We would not be able to have as many activities for kids to do. That's one of the ways the Friends enriches us.
The gallery offers the public a unique cultural experience and also a learning opportunity. There are a lot of people that may not go to an art gallery, but they come to the library. Having the gallery in the library captures people that may not go out of their way to go to a gallery.
Let's take a look at some of the pieces that the Friends of Art and the Friends of the Library have bought over the years. This one was a Friends of the Library Purchase Award from Topeka Competition 28. It's called Budding Artist. She said it was made of silver and plexiglass and an air plant. With the air plant, I asked her, will I be able to keep it alive? So what she did was constructed a plastic version for us to use after the air plant that was originally in the piece died.
That's pretty interesting. we talked
to her about it, and we wanted the piece to be true to her original concept, so the little plastic version, that one will last and let us keep presenting it for the future.
I really like the contemporary sleek look of this, too.
Yeah, she did a beautiful job in the construction. This bowl is by Elliot Pujol, and he has taught metalsmithing at K-State for years and years and years. What he's done with this bowl is taken a mesh and constructed it, folded it, and shaped it. Our next one is a bowl made of ceramic. It is earthenware by Gene Sievers. And this one is called Smoke in the Flint Hills. He has shaped and fired in a wood fire, so the dark smudges that you see, the areas of black and gray, would be a result of the smoke in the kiln. For the shape, where he has all these little tendrils, the way smoke would rise out of the Flint Hills, it's kind of a marvelous way to express something that happens every year when ranchers will burn their fields, and you just see these wafts and the shapes of the tendrils of the smoke. I like this piece. I think it's one of our coolest regional pieces.
Is that the reason that it was selected?
I think so, probably so. This one was from 1982, so it was another early competition. The Friends of Art, a couple years ago, purchased the third of a series of three works by Robert Ebendorf. These are called Portable Souls, and they are made from antique daguerreotype cases. The idea is that the image is an image of Christ, but probably something that Ebendorf found. When an artist picks up some material that is already made or something that most people might just throw away and uses it in their art, we call it found objects. And they're all put together into what looks like an antique icon.
I knew that we had
recently purchased the third one, mm-hmm. and I wasn't around for the first two, so I was interested in what Sherry would say about them.
Ebendorf had considered going into the seminary in his youth, and so a lot of his images will reflect the role of Jesus in his own life and his own spiritual contemplation.
The Friends of the Library and Library Friends of Art are very special because of their dedication over the years and because of their continued support and success for this library. They make us successful. They make us a wonderful experience for our customers and for our community. When the Friends of the Library and Friends of Art volunteer their time and their support, that lets us do things that we would not be able to do with taxpayer dollars. Something really, really wonderful for our community.